coming after it in front of the net. Canadian players hauled down, and there'll be a penalty on that call. And Corson doesn't like it. He comes up, and now look out. He and PJ Stock, who he ran into, get into it. A little shoving, pushing, and now Domi has the gloves gone to the ice. So something has developed here on the glass, and there are too many players, really, to see who's got who.
Shane Corson's going to get the original hooking penalty. Then your guess is as good as mine, although PJ Stock and Ty Domi are the most enthusiastic combatants, as everyone has a partner, but they seem to be only too serious about the dance. Although Bertrand is getting tangled up with Shane Corson. Multiple penalties, and I think probably the Leafs will get the extra man in the box, the original call on Shane Corson.
Oh yeah, that'll be the first one, no doubt about that. Whatever happens here, you would think it will be a power play for Montreal. The score is tied at one. Domi was the combatant, no doubt about that. He will sit it out for a while, and you can tell that Pat Quinn is not very happy with the call. We'll get it in a moment for you. Corson, as you mentioned, Harry, he has the first one. That'll be a minor.
Let's have a look how this whole routine started. Shane Corson will hook PJ Stock right off his feet here to get the penalty. You can see referee McCurry with his hand up. Then Domi comes in to talk that over with PJ Stock, and they get involved. So Montreal will have a power play. Their power play last night was 0-for-7, and in the last four games is 1-for-27. The Leafs' penalty killing is